Hello everyone, Denise Fleck, the Pet Safety Crusader here in business attire today because we're going to be talking about Pet Sitters International's 20th Take Your Dog to Work Day. But did you know the week kicked off with Take Your Cat to Work Day? And the whole week is Take Your Pet to Work Day. So there's so very much for us to talk about today. And I have to admit, I'm one of the lucky ones. I pretty much get to take my dog to work every day. However, my buddy Haiku, who you're going to only see on the poster back here, somehow thinks work today is kindergarten or something because he just decided to go take a nap in the bedroom. Go figure. But it's kind of starting to be a rainy day here, so I guess he figured it was nap time. He's has a full belly and has been outside. But what I do want to talk about is that, you know, I feel very privileged that I get to work almost every day with my furry best friend by my side. For a long time, it was furry best friends. And you've heard the Pet Safety Crusader talk about zoea before. Now, most of you know zoonotic diseases or the zoonosis. I'm having trouble with my Z's somehow. Zoonosis is the study of diseases that transfer between species, meaning things we can get from animals or things we can give to animals. Probably the most obvious one always is rabies. But those of us in the animal world know about Giardia and ringworm and coccidia and toxoplasmosis and all of these things that, you know, we can get from animals. Even tick born diseases like Lyme disease and Rocky Mountain spotted fever or ehrlichiosis and so on and so on, cytozoonosis for cats. But you've probably also heard me talk about zoea, the scientific proof that animals are good for our health. They increase our wellness and our health in so many ways. They make us exercise because dogs require walks. They sometimes are the final impetus to get people to kick the habit and quit smoking because we realize that that secondhand smoke is equally bad for our furry best friends in the house. They often get people that are either older or more shut in for some reason to get out and socialize with other people. And they do amazing things for us when we're young. They help us build up our immune systems. And there's actually scientific proof now that if you bond with an animal when you are young, it actually makes you grow into a more sympathetic and empathetic human being. So animals do so much for us on a daily basis. Why not see what they do for us by actually bringing them to the workforce? So Pet Sitters International is now in its 20th year of sponsoring Take Your Dog to Work Day. And it happens one fun Friday during the summer. It'll actually be tomorrow, June 22nd this year. But the week kicked off with Take Your Cat Day on Monday. And it's kind of been Take Your Pet to Work all week long. Now, before all of this happened, I actually tried it once when I was in the more corporate environment and more something more like this than you usually see me in my animal care duds. But I was working at Paramount Pictures as a publicist, and it was actually during the time we were working on the movie Lassie. And actually that kind of fit into this in that, you know, that week between Christmas and New Year's, things kind of shut down in a lot of businesses. So a friend of mine would always bring in his dog, Billy, who was a small little poodle, and Billy would bounce about the office, and everybody loved seeing Billy, and it just lifted everybody's spirits. So I thought I would bring in the Sunny Dog, my yellow lab, and you know, it sounded like it was going to be a great thing, and it actually turned out to be a great thing, but the minute we got into the building and got into the elevator, busted. The security guard was coming out of the elevator as we were getting in. And, you know, thinking quickly on my feet, I explained that she was an actress. And he let us proceed. And we went up to, I think it was the third floor of the Marathon building at that time. And Sunny spent the day. I did realize, though, especially being in even though a short high rise, she hadn't been in an elevator before, but she did really well. And I've learned with subsequent animals to, you know, desensitize them and teach them about some of those things. But I think it also was a little frustrating for her initially, because every time she went in a door, she still wasn't outside. So, you know, we certainly worked in those potty breaks and all, but that was my first introduction to actually taking my dog to work before this whole thing came about. And like I said, I got busted, but it turned out to be just fine. And I want to really talk to you about the event coming up tomorrow, how it can help, but some things, you know, being the Pet Safety Crusader, that I want you to keep in mind, because anytime you bring animals and people together in a situation that the animal may not be used to, it can end up being a fabulous experience for everyone, but you just want to make sure you set up the animal to succeed. And like I told you, this week kicked off with Take Your Cat to Work Day, and I'm going to show you some photos. This is a new friend I've just been introduced to by Pet Sitters International. This is Brittany, and I believe Brittany is joining us, and she'll have to tell us the name of the kitty cat here. But Brittany works at Tail Activewear, and they are in their second year of participating in Take Your Dog to Work Day. So they're getting all geared up for tomorrow. So Brittany, I see you're here. Please respond as I ask away, but I'm going to talk about you guys a little bit. Last year they did it for the first time, and this was their little promo piece, and they raised money for Pets for Patriots. So not only did they bring animals to the office to really create a wonderful mood for everyone, they're doing something else I'm going to share with you in a moment, but they actually raised money for an animal organization, which I think is just awesome. And here is the kitty again enjoying Take Your Cat to Work Day this past Monday at Tail Activewear. Okay, cool. Forgive me, I hadn't met Brittany in person, so that was actually her coworker Kelsey and her cat Raven. So Brittany, glad to have you here. And her pup is Charlie the Dachshund, who you see in this picture. Sorry, I would never know which way to go, right or left. What a little cutie pie. So what they've been doing all month long is on their bulletin board, so that clients can see as they walk into Tail Activewear, is this great bulletin board full of pets that need to be adopted. And Brittany, tell us which organization this is for. I believe she's in the Savannah, Georgia area, kind of a little bit more than a stone's throw from me, but not too much farther. And this has just been an awesome way for them to help out these animals in need by posting the pictures, getting people excited about Take Your Dog to Work Day, and letting them know what animals need to be adopted. But I believe they're also going to be giving, I'm just looking here on my list, a donation to this great organization come the end of this. It's the Humane Society of Greater Savannah, and they're donating $500. So that's awesome. Not only are pets coming, and right now they're scheduled to have five dogs in attendance on Friday, but they've been doing this all month long, letting people know about adoptable animals. And yes, I'm glad she's got it up here for me. The adoptable animals are all at the Humane Society of Greater Savannah in Georgia, and they're donating too. So, you know, this is an amazing thing that Patty Moran, Beth Stoltz, and the whole Pet Sitters International team has put together and continues to do. And it's just a great way to get pets and people together. If you go to the Pet Sitters International website, petsit.com, you can download this great toolkit they have here, and it gives you everything you need to really succeed and make this a successful day. There are just all kinds of samples of like a dogs at work policy and things you should think about. But, you know, again, as the Pet Safety Crusader, I want to go over some of their 7 tips to make sure that the day is a success. And this can be just such a fun thing. I realize it's tomorrow. Some of you may not have known about it. Some of you may not have time to plan. Maybe you can, you know, get everybody on board and everybody can, you know, some one person can quickly bring a dog. Or it's something really to look forward to next year and make it a part of your company's, you know, ongoing protocol to have that one fun Friday every summer. First of all, though, you always want to do an office check. You want to make sure everybody's on board. There could be somebody highly allergic to animals. There could be somebody very fearful. You know, anytime us animal people are out there, we have to be extra sensitive because, like me having Akitas, it's one of those things I always worry about. You know, just like many of you that have pit bulls in your life, they've got this stigma attached to them. And whenever we're out with our pets, we have to make sure we're ambassadors for the breed, or just being ambassadors for pet parents, that we aren't, you know, ticking anybody off and rubbing anybody the wrong way. So make sure everybody is on board, and if somebody is imposed in any way, see if there's a way to work it out. Maybe you won't end up actually bringing animals, but you'll do something awesome like Brittany had planned here with showing dogs that are available, for adoption, donating to a cause, doing something like that. But maybe you can even work it around so that the animals are only at one wing of the office, or you keep them behind a doggy gate in your own office. There are always ways around it, but just check with everyone. Secondly, you need to puppy-proof your workspace, and that can even mean if you have an older dog or a cat. You pretty much have your house down, but your office may have candy out and about. You may have electric cords all over the place. You may have, magic markers or correction fluid or toner for printers, things that they can get into or get tangled into. Again, like I said with Sunny, she did really well with, I hear him. Maybe he'll join us before he's woken from his nap. But she did really well with the elevator. But another time I had to take my black lab, Mr. Rico, and it was a struggle because you have to practice some of those things. Floor surfaces feel different. They may be used to carpet. You may have a tile floor in the office. So there's a lot of things to think about just to keep those, dangers out of paw's reach. And you might, just want to make sure that you bring their crate or have one of those little portable gates in your office doorway so that your pet can, get a timeout if needed. You absolutely want to make sure your dog or your cat or whatever pet you're bringing is fit and ready to come, meaning, please have him groomed and have a bath. Make sure he's up to date on vaccinations, that he isn't sick or recuperating. If it's the time he's having a kidney infection or is on prednisone and is having to pee and go out a lot, and drink a lot of water, that may not be the best time to do it. So just make sure he's, ready to go and that it is a well-socialized pet, just simply for the reason I mentioned. You've got to think of that dog as an ambassador for other dogs, and he's representing the whole canine pack there, so to speak. So you want him to, put his best foot forward, so to speak. You also want a dog bag. You're going to need his food, his treat, his water bowls. Maybe you're going to even need to bring bottled water or water from home because the one out of the faucet may taste different to him. Of course, a pet first aid kit just in case he has an upset tummy or something happens along the way. His bed, whatever you need to keep him comfortable and allow him to have his own space too. Maybe his favorite toy or chew stick. Additionally, think about feeding time. If he's going to go in the car, you don't want to feed him right before if he gets an upset tummy and vice versa. If you have a meeting scheduled at a certain point in the day and he's going to have to stay in your office with maybe somebody watching him that can't take him out for a walk, you need to think about that depending on how quickly he needs to go after he eats. But make sure you bring along everything for his needs. Don't forget medications or supplements. Keep his routine as normal as you can, even though he's in a different environment. Don't force anybody to interact with your pet. You may have the fluffiest, cutest bundle of fur, ever, but if somebody's uncomfortable, let it be. It's not good for the dog, and it's not good for the person. So that's why I said it's important to make sure everybody's on board, but also that you have a place for the pet to retreat to if it's getting a little chaotic. Because remember, he may be looking at shins and knees most of the day and might need a little chill out time. Also, just observe all of the coworkers and make sure they know that the chocolate kisses on their desk aren't a good thing for your dog to have, to not feed them the grapes and raisins from their bagged lunch. You really need, like you always are, to be that diligent pet parent. And then finally, number 7 is have an exit strategy. It is possible it can be overwhelming for your pet. So make a plan that you've spoken with your supervisor ahead of time that should the need arise, you can take that half hour, 45 minutes, hour, whatever it is, to drive your pet home and then get back to the office. Have that professional pet sitter on standby that could possibly even come to the office and take your pet home. Whatever it is, just always have a plan B. I always talk about this with first aid and disaster preparedness, but it's like if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. And what are my other cliches? If you prepare for the worst, it's unlikely that the worst will happen. So just keep these things in mind. But since I have Brittany here, I'd love to talk to her a little bit about how the first Take Your Dog to Work Day came about at Tail Activewear. So anything you can tell me about, you know, whose idea it was to participate in this Pet Sitters International event, if everybody was on board, if it, you know, took a little bit of time to get everybody on board, or, you know, how that went for you. And while you're at it, I'm giving you a lot of things to type to me here, but I'd love to know what Tail stands for, since we're talking about animals and it's called Tail Activewear, and I certainly looked on their website and they've got some great exercise outfits, so I encourage everybody to take a peek at that. I actually am going to be, because my new elliptical just arrived today, so I'm in the market to get some workout wear. But yeah, it's actually sitting on the doorstep waiting for my husband to get home and build it. But okay, here she's starting here. So she learned about Take Your Dog to Work Day when she was interning for another company in North Carolina. The owner of the company brought her dog to the office every day, and it really made that office a happier environment. Well, those of you that are tuned into this, you know that's true. If we felt stressed or needed a break from what we were working on, we could go play with a cute dog and come back to our work refreshed. Absolutely. You know, they're allowing dogs to come into courtroom situations to calm the defendants. Very often you'll hear in colleges, even sometimes in high schools, during exam weeks, there are dogs available in, you know, certain areas that if somebody's really stressed out, they can come and hang with the dog for a little while. Obviously, after some of the terrible things that have been happening at schools, the shootings, they bring in therapy dogs too. And we've known forever and ever and ever that, you know, therapy dogs come to hospitals, whether they're for children or for adults. And they really do settle our nerves. They just make us feel better about life and ourselves. Because when you're looking into those big brown, green, whatever color adoring eyes, all your troubles melt away. And you know, with a pet, you always have a confidant and a friend who's really gonna be there for you and help you feel better. So everyone in their office at Tail Activewear loves animals. Well, that, you know, kind of made it a no-brainer that they would participate in this day. They're always sharing photos and stories about our animals. Our kind of people, aren't they? Everyone has a calendar with each month featuring photos of one of the pets, and Tail cares about their employees. I'm just trying to see if I can click on this. Yes, I can. So that I can read it all here. So she already knew about Pet Sitters International Take Your Dog to Work Day and figured it would be an easy sell. So that is so awesome, and apparently it went really well the first time, so they, you know, are doing it again this year. I'm gonna see if I can scroll down here. I don't wanna lose everybody here while I'm doing this. But Brittany has a lot of good information, but please, you know, feel free to go ahead and read what she has to say. Let me also ask her if there were any special preparations that had to be made, you know, for the animals to come to work. Because like I mentioned, do things have to be put away out of paw's reach? I saw on Monday you had a kitty cat. So was the cat allowed to free roam? Did the cat need to be in a harness? And I may not read all of this to all of you right now, because you can certainly go back through the comments and see what it's all about. I know you don't need me to read to you. But I'm just so interested in this, and any information Brittany can share with us might be helpful for any other companies out there that are hoping to participate in Take Your Dog to Work Day, Take Your Pet to Work Week, Take Your Cat to Work Monday next year, or at any point in the future. So Brittany, feel free to write away anything else you have to share, and what it's like just having the animals around there. Now, Brittany and I have been talking, and I know it may be, you know, a chaotic day, because it's almost like having a field trip when you're in school or having a special event going on. And things, you know, may not run on the normal time schedule. But if there's any way possible, we're going to try to do a little recording of what's happening at her office tomorrow with the dogs, the five dogs there visiting for the day. And if at all possible, you know, I will bring that back to you later in the day tomorrow on Facebook. So I hope that'll work out. But if not, I'm just going to know that they're having a great time at the office. And if any of you, others of you out there have done a Take Your Dog to Work Day, please, you know, chime in here. Tell us how it went, if there were any things you wish you had done differently, or something that you thought just was stellar. Because we all know having an animal by our side really makes everything in life better. So I'm just so excited that my friends at Pet Sitters International continue to do this Take Your Dog to Work Day. Granted, it's only one day of the year, but we do have them in our hearts and in our homes, you know, the other 364 or 65, depending on if it's a leap year or not. But I'm trying to scroll down, but while I'm on here, it's not really letting me scroll, and I don't want to lose the feed here. So I'm not being able to see the rest of the comments right now. But please, everybody, take the time to come and read these, because I think they're very beneficial if this is something you might want to do. And you can do this if you, you know, work in a small mom and pop type store, or if you actually work in a corporation. So, you know, again, depending on the size of your office, the number of the people, the logistics, it, you know, may take a little bit more planning. But I think this is such an awesome thing to do because, like I said, animals, you know, just totally enhance our life, our mood, and actually our productivity. I'm just looking over. Here's some other things you can get off the Pet Sitters International website. Their at-work policy. And, you know, it's just common sense stuff. If you bring your dog in, you're not going to just sit at your desk and do whatever it is you do all day and let the dog roam about. You're responsible for that animal, and you need to keep an eye on him. And anything can happen, including him get hurt or lost, as well as, you know, some sort of ruckus going on with the other dogs there. But I just think this is an awesome thing. It's fun to talk about. I look forward to seeing the pictures from all the other companies around the states that are doing this. Today, I'm sure some of that will be made available from PSI, but this is an awesome thing. So if you didn't know about it, think about making a plan for next year for your office. And just, you know, even if you're working from home like I do so often, make sure you take a time out and you're really in the moment with that dog or cat or other animal in your life. We do get so involved in what we're doing, and I often think haikus, thinking, why is she staring at that black little box all the time? How fun can that be? So, you know, it does you good every hour or so to get up, stretch your legs, and really tune in to your best friend. Thanks so much for listening today. I was so grateful that Brittany and Tail Activewear came on to join in. And everybody out there having a Take Your Dog to Work Day tomorrow, paws crossed and fingers too. For great success and lots of love with our canine best pals. Bye-bye for now.